Almighty God, I thank you for this morning and I bless your name. Mighty God, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable unto your sight, my Savior and my Redeemer. O Lord, amen. I will be speaking to you this morning from the scripture, Psalm 16, verse 8. And I will be reading from the New International Version. And it reads thus: I keep my eyes always on the Lord. With him at my right hand, I will not be shaken. Another version says, I will not be moved. So, whether we are drivers, or whether we are passengers, or whether we are athletes, we know the importance of lanes. Every one of us, as children of God, has an assigned lane. Staying in these lanes prevents accidents. It prevents us from getting into detours. It prevents us with no shortcuts. Staying in our lanes takes us to our destinations in the kingdom of God. It will take us to our destinies. In other words, as my topic this morning is, stay in your lane. If we take a look at the track events at an Olympics, for example, the 100 meters, the 200 meters, the hurdles, the 400 meters, just to name a few, every runner has been given a pre-assigned lane to run in from start to finish. Now, there are always eight lanes, and each lane is only 4 feet wide. And any runner who runs outside his or her assigned lane, even if it is just a small body part that is outside of the assigned lane, that athlete is disqualified. Looking at the Christian race, which is much higher than the Olympics, there's some people who want to get out of their assigned lane to run the race and think that they will win this race or they will gain the prize. There are so many positive experiences when we stay in our lane while we run this race. There is a heavenly reward. We will reap a crown of righteousness. We will obtain the approval of our Heavenly Father as he tells us, well done, thou good and faithful servant. Have you ever been driving and everything seems to be going good and then suddenly the lane slows up? You look to the right, you look to the left, you try to get up, you know, to look over the steering wheel, but you cannot move that car. You look at your watch. You look at the clock on the dashboard. You change the radio channel. You take a sip of water. You start to get impatient and agitated. So now, as soon as you see a little way out, you swing real fast into the lane that seem to be moving real fast. But as soon as you switch that lane slows down. And the one that you were in begins to move real fast. Well, it is the same thing with us on this journey. Sometimes we think that our assigned lane is going too slow when God has really placed us there for a purpose, to grow some more spiritually, to be strengthened, to trust him more, to lean on him, to depend solely on him. But in the midst of it, we switched lanes with bad choices. Not the devil who did it. It's us. We made the poor decisions. We made the poor choices. And so we slowed down our own progress because we could not wait by staying in the lane that seems slow. I encourage you this morning, family, no matter how it may seem, stay in your assigned lane. Do you want to remain in your lane? Stay focused on Jesus. Put on spiritual blinders. Don't be distracted with all the weights and the heavy things that so easily beset us. Take them off. Shake them off. Get rid of them. Get rid of them in Jesus' mighty name. Get rid of anything or anyone that slows you down. Even if it's your friend or even if it's a family member, let them go. You cannot carry a lot with you. Stay in the will of God. Operate in your own God-given authority and don't compare yourself with others. And while you are driving on life's journey highway or running the race, if the sign says uneven lane and it seems like everyone else is getting ahead of you, but the opportunities seem uneven, it seems unfair, God's got you. It will all even out in the end. So stay in your lane. If the sign says lane ends, stay in the lane. Because when that lane ends, God has already prepared a new lane for you. Fresh start, new beginning. Great things are ahead. If the sign says lanes merge, stay in your lane. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Simply say, yes, Lord, because he is merging you with your destiny helpers. He is merging you with the promises of your life. He is merging you with the doors that he has opened for you. Staying in your lane that is assigned by God, it prevents the death of your destiny. Staying in your lane that is assigned by God prevents spontaneous abortion of what God has placed inside of you to give birth to. Staying in your lane that is assigned by God prevents confusion. So I encourage you this morning, stay in your lane to get the prize. Stay in your lane through the storms. Stay in your lane through the setbacks. Stay in your lane through the battles. 2 Chronicles 20 verse 15b states, this is what the Lord says. Do not be afraid or discouraged because of this vast number, for the battle is not yours, but God's. All you have to do is to take up your position, run the race, and while you're running the race or driving on life's journey boulevard, keep your eyes on Jesus. Focus on God's promises. Focus on God's plan. Focus on God's almighty power. Now, my question to you this morning, are you ready to run your race? Are you ready to drive on life's journey road? So let's do this. Jesus Christ is with you. No matter where you go, no matter what happens, he is right there with you. As long as you keep your eyes on him, remember, he is at your right hand. So are you ready to go? On your mark, get set, go. But remember, stay in your lane. God bless you. Almighty God, I thank you for your word. And mighty God, we will stay in our lane because mighty God, we will receive the prize. Mighty God, we will receive all that you have in store for us this morning. And so, Lord, we say amen to your will and to your way in Jesus' mighty name.